Good day to all my students in Integral Calculus. Today we are going to discuss integrals leading to logarithm. Now if we recall the general power formula, which is the integral of u to the n du is equal to u raised to n plus 1 all over n plus 1 plus c, where n is not equal to negative 1. Now, if n is equal to negative 1, then the formula becomes the integral of u to the negative 1 du, where u to the negative 1 is just equal to 1 over u. So the integral of 1 over u du is now equal to ln of the absolute value of u plus c. So this is now our formula for integral leading to logarithm. Now, if we go to our first example, if you will be dealing with an integral term that is a fractional form, you might as well consider using the formula of integral leading to logarithm. Okay? I'm not saying that every time you are faced with an integral term that is a fractional form, the only formula that can be applied is the formula leading to logarithm. That is exactly not true. What I can say is you can start considering this formula if you are dealing with an integral term that is a fractional form, like our first example, wherein the integral of x squared all over x cubed plus 1 dx, of course, this is a fractional form. Now, if we are to really target the formula 1 over u, therefore, we let our denominator x cubed plus 1 as our u. Okay? Always let the denominator as your u if you are going to consider applying the formula of integral leading to logarithm. So if our u is x cubed plus 1, therefore du is 3x squared dx. Now if we look at the given integral term, if this is our u, what remains above is x squared dx. And yet our du is 3x squared dx coming from our u. So since we only have x squared dx, if we write the term, the integral of 3x squared dx over x cubed plus 1, where 3x squared dx is our du, and x cubed plus 1 is our u, we need to multiply a correcting factor of 1 over 3 to the integral term in order for the term not to change to any value. Okay? So this is now our integral term. Obviously, if you divide 3 by 3, just equal to 1. So you go back to the original integral term, that is x squared dx all over x cubed plus 1. Now, since 3x squared dx is our du, and x cubed plus 1 is our u, we just apply the formula, is just equal to 1 over 3 ln of u plus c. Substituting back our u, which is x cubed plus 1, the final answer, therefore, is the integral of x squared all over x cubed plus 1 dx is equal to 1 over 3 ln of the quantity of x cubed plus 1 quantity plus c. Okay? You can also write the absolute value symbol here. So this is now a right answer. For our next integral, you have the integral of x squared plus 2 all over x plus 1 dx. So again, this is a fractional form. First thing to do is we need to simplify by breaking this into sum of fractions. So first step is we break this into two fractions. That is the sum of the integral of x squared all over x plus 1 dx, and you have now the remaining fractional term, which is 2 times the integral of 1 over x plus 1 dx. Okay? The first integral term needs to be simplified also by dividing. So dividing x squared over x plus 1. So this is our first integral term will lead us to the integral of a quantity x minus 1 quantity plus 1 over x plus 1 quantity dx. This is just the simplification of the first integral term. So if we go back to the given integral term, we copy this one for our first integral term and copy also the second integral term as is. Okay? Now if you look at carefully, this is 1 over x plus 1. This is also 1 over x plus 1. And this is plus, and this is plus. So you can add these two terms. Since this is 1 and this is 2, the coefficient of this term is 1 and this is 2, adding this will result to 3. And distributing dx here, the next step is the integral of the quantity x minus 1 dx plus 3, the integral of 1 over x plus 1 dx. Okay? I hope you're able to follow. Now, the first term is actually power formula. Okay? So if we let, this is for the first term, if we let x minus 1 as our u, then our du will be dx. So substituting this to the first integral term, you will have the integral of u du plus 3 integral of 1 over x plus 1 dx. Now for the second integral term, if we let x plus 1 as our u, then du will be dx also. So we have now the integral of x squared plus 2 all over x plus 1 dx is now equal to the integral of u du plus 3 the integral of 1 over u du. Now using the power formula for the first integral term will give us u squared plus 2. For the second term, integral leading to formula, so you have 3 ln of u plus c. Substituting back our u for the first term is x minus 1, and our u for the second term is x plus 1. So substituting back our u, the final answer is the integral of x squared plus 2 all over x plus 1 dx is equal to the quantity x minus 1 quantity squared all over 2 plus 3 ln of x plus 1 quantity plus c. Okay, I hope you're able to follow. Now, for our third example, so you have now the integral of 1 over y ln of y dy. Now, this is quite tricky, but if you let y as your u, then your du will just equal to dy. So, what happens to our ln of y? So, you can try letting ln of y as our u. And if you get the differential of ln y, you will have 1 over y dy. So exactly a formula leading to logarithm. So substituting the integral of 1 over y ln of y dy is just equal to the integral of 1 over u du, which is equal to ln of u plus c. Since our u is ln of y, so our final answer will be the integral of 1 over y ln of y dy is equal to ln of y quantity plus c. Okay? So we have discussed now sample problems on integrals leading to logarithm. The next video will be about integrals of exponential functions.